I am extremely grateful to the students' organizations who came from the city and who protested peacefully and who also made a mark that this gate will be opened, and they opened the gate. Now the rule of the police cannot last long, and we know what is a university. University is a place where debates take place, where opposite ideas clash, opposite ideologies clash. That is the place. No idea can be suppressed by any force. It is better that V.C. Apparao understands this and his henchmen. Ideas cannot be suppressed, and in a university we invite even so-called, what we call, I should not call, they claim they are patriots of this country. These patriots who are selling this country, who are attacking one university after the other. They attacked Central University. They claimed that there are anti-national forces here. There are casteist forces here. There are terrorist forces here. And on the other hand, they are declaring this university has a great rank in the country. Now, can casteist forces actually, it is anti-caste forces. It is a wrong word to use. What are the forces here who are fighting? They are fighting against caste annihilation of Ambedkar's agenda. It is, we have to pity Bandara Dattatreya because he cannot understand things. He has been talking on behalf of his party. And university is a place for autonomy. I want to quote one incident. Even bourgeois leaders like Jawaharlal Nehru, when he went to Delhi University, it appeared, he said that I want to enter the university only with the permissions of the vice chancellor, because vice chancellors are at that time of that type. And he took the permission, he went inside. That is the respect given to a university. But what is happening to this Ramchandar Rao? What is happening to this Bandara Dattatreya or other BJP leaders who just enter into the university and say to vice chancellor, you teach a lesson to Ambedkar Students Association, otherwise I will teach a lesson. We have warned, this is a university, Mr. Ramchandra Rao. At least you realize now, you realize that university is a place for discussion. If you have a power of idea, you come and debate. We are challenging from this platform. If you say you are nationalist, if you say you are for the country, let us discuss, debate, we will conduct, we will allow you. But don't think that you will win with this police force and with Apparao as your henchman. I am also trying to, I am not going to speak much, but I want to tell you that the students' organizations who came here, they were arrested. Some of them are in Panjagutta police station. They were calling us. What is the crime they have done? They have done that in a university you cannot rule with the police. That's why hundreds of students came and they have argued with the police. They have entered the gate. But we also say one thing. Inside the university also, controller of examination has resigned from the academic council of the meeting. This may be the first time in the history of any university. Academic council, basically it is managed and conducted by the controller of examination. He has resigned, he has come out. I also want to inform one more thing. Nandini Sundar from Delhi University, famous professor, he said to Apparao, Apparao, you have lost moral authority to govern this university. I cannot stay in this. What more you require? If you have a minimum sense of values, if you are a human being, let alone whatever you are, what to say to these people who have no values? There are no difference. There is no difference between him and any person. Actually, many people have values except these people. Now, That's why I am saying that through power can they rule. Through power of the gun, through power of the stick, can you suppress the ideas? Can you suppress the intellectuals? We are only saying history does not support your argument. Such people have gone into the dustbin of the history. Please remind yourself. And now, only one point I want to make. When Appara went on leave, university became peaceful. Classes began, labs run, everything is peaceful, it is coming to normalcy. But on 22nd March, Appara came without informing anybody, by informing few teachers who are his chelas, by informing some a section of students. He came in with the help of the police. Can any vice chancellor enter his own office with police and this kind of, and ABVP inside his house?
Shame.
And only after he came, the entire university became disturbed. Why it is disturbed? Why you came so fast? One of the important reason I will tell and close this. Before that, Professor Periaswamy, he was the in-charge vice-chancellor. He organized a meeting of heads and deans and he told that there is a caste discrimination inside the campus. This is the first time any vice-chancellor openly went on saying in the press, this university has a caste discrimination. He has a guts to say. Of course he has a background. He's from the OBC community. Since he is from the OBC community, this Brahminical order did not allow him to continue. He also said that students' scholarship should be increased from 8,000 to 25,000. He said that I have some goodwill. He's a famous professor. He talked to the TST and others that our university is no less than IITs. Therefore, the fellowship should be increased. And these people who claim themselves as teachers. No, please. So those teachers who are sitting as heads and deans, they opposed this proposal of increasing fellowship, you understand. But their salary should increase. Now 7th pay commission is coming. Professors are looking for salaries, how to. But for students, they don't want fellowship to be increased. And the other important thing which Periaswamy said, that the students who are coming from the rural background, Dalit background, they cannot write maybe in the beginning in English, they should be given a chance of an interview. Now these proposals were not liked by the so-called local EC, executive committee, and also the heads and deans. That's why they have planned on 22nd in a way to forcefully bring Appara into the campus to impose the same caste order here, because Periaswamy wanted to remove at least bit by bit this caste discrimination inside the campus. So therefore, I want to, because there are many speakers, I am very happy here. We have with us J.P. Rajgaru, who is a well-known fighter for the scheduled caste and scheduled tribes in this part of the country. And we have many students' organizations. We have also other organizations, speakers are here. I request the organizers to also give them chance to speak to us to express their solidarity. Thank you very much.